My name is Amanda and welcome to Lunar Elements. This is for the Libra Moon Transit between the 22nd and 24th of May, and this is for Earth signs, so Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Now, the most powerful thing that's going to be happening during this Moon Transit is that we're going to be seeing Station retrograde at 13 degrees of Aquarius. It's going to be retrograding back through till October the 11th to the 6th degree. And now when we think of this, we're thinking of 1847 when it retrograded over these same degrees. And that's like Claude Monet and Renoir. And we're also going back to 1668. Now when we think of 1847, we're thinking of when the Freedman Bank was foreclosed because it was found out to be quite corrupt in its dealings. So the Freedman Bank was founded for the emancipated communities of those African American slaves, and they lost the equivalent of something like today's standard of $80 million, you know. So considering I'm here in Australia, when I was researching this, the Westpac Bank came up straight away because of things that were disclosed last year in their dealings and their, it's like, underhanded dealings and what they're affiliated with. So that comes to mind. And when we go back to 1668, we're speaking of the end of the War of Devolution. We are speaking of the Arc de la Chapelle, which was the treaty that was formed with the Triple Alliance between the English and the Swedes, I believe, and the Dutch. And also we're looking at things like when the French army like sent an incursion through into Catalonia in Spain, which is Catalan is a small province within Spain, and that's why it has its own dialect, unlike the rest of Spain. Its Spanish isn't straight Spanish. So when we're looking back to those sorts of things, and you know, King Louis and Leopold were involved in this, we're also looking at when Panama City was burned down, you know. And also I'm getting the histories, I'm attempting to remember the histories correctly. I'm unsure if it was 1847 or 1668, or 1874, sorry, or 1668, but that was when Bombay was sold to the East India Trading Company. So what I'm feeling is that not only will this Saturn retrograde be so powerful, because the last time we saw Saturn retrograde from Aquarius back into Capricorn was May of 2020, and we all know what happened then. So prior to that, we're also looking at May of through to October of 1992 as well. So I really advise you all to look to your natal charts and your progressions to see where, which house Aquarius falls in, so that you know how this Saturn retrograde is going to play out in your life through May through 23rd when it stations, through to the 11th of October when it stations again to move direct, you know. So I think I'll leave that there for the astro intro. Also stay tuned to this channel because I have a divine announcement coming very, very soon, and within the next 24 hours. So let's get into it. Taurus, we'll start off with you. Taurus, this is hitting off in your sixth house, and you've got the Eight of Wands coming out already, which is quite nice considering the sixth house is ruled by Virgo and thus Mercury, but it also rules our day-to-day in relation to our work and our job. So perhaps there's a pay rise or something like that that you've been wanting to ground in and really have come to fruition. Perhaps there's been some documentation on the table with regards to Ace of Pentacles just flipped out of the deck. Perhaps there's been speak of you having like a managerial shift was what I was hearing as that was flipping out. Like, I'm just getting chills right now on my left-hand side. So perhaps this is something that in the past you didn't think you wanted, but now you're going to be stepping up into that role. And with that will come a pay rise, because the Eight of Wands is that fast messages, communication coming in, you know. It's also a card for travel, but I'm feeling it's a manifestation energy. So can we please have two more cards for Taurus for the Libra Moon Transit? Thank you. The Three of Pentacles, which is amazing. And what else? Can we please have one more card? There it is. The Five of Cups. And this other one here wanted to come out, which is the Justice card. So you have the Ace of Pentacles, the Three of Pentacles, and the Five of Cups with the Justice card. And they're telling me straight away right now, Taurus, if there's any sadness going on in your life with this Justice card coming out here, this is the card for Libra, thus Venus as well, okay? But they're telling me straight away, Jupiter's ingress back into Pisces, we haven't seen that since January 18th, 2010. So perhaps there's a karmic closeout that you need to solidify within yourself and reconcile within your own being. But with the Ace of Pentacles and the Three of Pentacles coming out off the back of what we were just speaking about this potential job, I can't even think of the word right now. It's not just a pay rise. It's like you're stepping up into the up in the ranks, so to speak. And you do rule the throat as well. So if you're needing to speak up, especially if it's coming back from something from the past, which as I was getting chills up my left side before when we were speaking about this role, you know, maybe perhaps this role wasn't something that you wanted to do earlier on in your career or earlier on in your life. You know, it doesn't have to be a 9-to-5 job either. Can we get a clarifier for this? There it is, spread please. Yeah, the Hermit card, which is the card for Virgo, Taurus, fellow earth sign. So I feel that it would be really wise for you to really go within and have a really deep introspection of what is it that you really want, that you can form those solid foundations with the Three of Pentacles coming out. This is the plan for the card for planning. So this here, the architects are speaking with the people who look after the church, I believe, and the Three of Pentacles, they're really drawing me to the rose as well, down the bottom just here, the rose, like the Rosicrucians, is that how you say that word? But the Three of Pentacles, that is a card for solid planning, you know, and with the Ace of Pentacles, I really feel that if it is something that you want, perhaps with this Hermit card here, if you take the time, because the underlying messages is the Seven of Pentacles, so if and the Moon, yeah. So if you take the time and go within, get honest with yourself, okay. Also, thank you so much. I've got a lot of messages coming in right now, all on top of one another, because this spread is like there's two or three different messages going on. With the Seven of Pentacles and the Moon, okay, straight away I'm feeling that there is something underlying here for you where there's a lack of belief, okay, that you can actually do the job, or that you even want to do the job. So I think that's why the Hermit's being delivered here, is the overall message is that it's time to go in and actually ask yourself, is it what I really want? Is it what I really want to invest my future in, you know? And with the Five of Cups and the Justice card, again, as soon as I saw that Five of Cups, I got told Jupiter in my ear. So that takes us back to the 18th of January 2010. So perhaps it's time to have a review of your, not just of your past, but, you know, like, where do you need healing from the past? Where do you need to find reconciliation within yourself, you know, Taurus? So I'm going to leave it there. I hope you like this video. Please stay tuned for the next video that will drop after this series, because it will be the announcement that I've been sitting on for just over a month now to be able to announce to everybody. I've been so excited, it's been really difficult to hold it in, but please like, share and subscribe to this video and drop it in the comments if it resonated. I'd love to hear it. Also, don't forget to check out your Sun, Moon and Rising, and also remember your progressed Sun, Moon and Rising as well, because that will give you a deeper introspection and inner standing of what energies you are traversing in this year of your life, Taurus, okay? All right, so let's move on to Virgo. Virgo, excuse me. This is hitting off in your second house of Taurus, that's Venus. And what messages do we have for Virgo, please? They're saying straight away, Virgo, value your heart. That's the first message. Value your heart. What does your heart say? What has your heart been saying, you know? And where is Aquarius in your natal chart and in your progressions, you know? What house? Because this will be, excuse me. I've done a lot of readings over the last few days because I'm moving house soon. So I've had to do a lot of recordings back to back and get a lot of other things done as well. So, excuse me. They said, yeah, so value your heart. What does your heart tell you? They're just saying that don't overspend your money right now. Don't overspend on things because you're feeling like an emptiness or a void in here, especially if you have like your moon or your Venus in your second house, you know. Be very, very, very wary of spending to make yourself feel better. And also, yes, absolutely. Thank you. They're also saying to definitely check where Aquarius is in your chart, because then you'll be able to see how it's going to be aspecting your other planets. So what cards do we have, please, for Virgo? Here they are. The Eight of Wands. That's beautiful energy. That's manifestation energy that came out for Taurus as well. And so considering this moon, Libra moon, is going to be transiting, which is also ruled by Venus, right? So next card out, the Ten of Pentacles. What was I saying about your money? They're both Taurus, both the second house, Taurus and Libra, all ruled by Venus, which relates to our value and how we acquire and build money as well. So I feel that this season, this transit, you might have a bit of a windfall, they call it. Last card, please, for Virgo. I'm seeing 2,000, so maybe somebody's receiving a $2,000 check or something, or, you know, or maybe you've just put out a course, and yeah, I'm getting told masterclass, mastermind right now, mastermind. Last card, please, for Virgo. Oh, there it is. Yep, the Hierophant. So perhaps you're teaching. Perhaps there's something that you've been waiting to launch. I feel that this Libra moon transit, especially because now we're seeing the sun has entered, is two days in. As of the 21st, the sun moved into, or 20th, sorry, The sun moved into Gemini, you know, and Gemini is the communicator, which is what the Eight of Wands is. It's fast messages coming in, you know. So if there's something that you need to get out there, and this is also the card for Taurus as well, which is, it's coming through and transiting your second house of Taurus. So if there is something that you've been waiting to get out there, whether it's an email to somebody to be like, well, look, you actually owe me. What's coming through right now is you actually owe me, you owe me money back pay, you know, is what I'm feeling. For those of you who are working in a normal job, and I'm feeling 1800, 18 is the number they're giving me for that. But with those of you who are waiting, who are, you know, running your own business and doing your own soul purpose work and things like that, and you've got the Ace of Pentacles as the underlying energy here, you can't make this shit up, guys. Like, Virgo, you've got a lot coming in for you. And I feel, yeah, thank you, the Knight of Pentacles. And I feel that if it doesn't come through, with the Knight of Pentacles being the overall energy, it's the slowest moving knight of the deck, right? So if it doesn't come in during this Libra moon transit, I feel that, like, it won't be far off. They're just saying after the eclipse on the 26th, because the 26th is going to be a full moon lunar eclipse in Sagittarius. And you just had another card fall out of the deck. It's the Fool card, you know. So if there's something that you've been waiting on to launch, get out of your head. I'm seeing Five of Swords, the Hermit card, Nine of Wands, and the King of Wands, and the Page of Cups as the underlying energies here. So yeah, that's crazy. And one card has flipped over in the deck. I missed it. It's the Seven of Cups reversed. Wow. I'm just checking to see if there are any others. No. Okay. So you're very assured with the Seven of Cups being reversed, okay? What I feel is that, like, there's this second chance of something that you're working on prior, and now it's time to launch it, you know, get it out there, get it finalized, okay? Because with the Knight of Pentacles is the, coming out as the clarifier, and then the Fool and the Seven of Cups reversed wanting to come out, I just feel like with the underlying energies being the Five of Swords, Hermit, and Nine of Wands, right? They're just saying that failure is never failure. Failure is just a lesson, you know, and it's not the failure in itself that defines you. It's how you handle it is what they're telling me right now. So, yeah. Thank you. Virgo, considering Neptune has returned to Pisces, I really implore you, go and have a look at what degree your sun, moon, or rising is, okay? Like, I'm a 22 degree sun Virgo natally. Progressed, I'm a 0 degree Scorpio, you know, like, because of my age. Like, that's how big a difference it makes in our lives. Excuse me. However, being a 22 degree sun Virgo, okay, my sun right now is directly opposite Neptune in Pisces because it's at 22 degrees, you know. So this has been a very, very powerful and potent time for my intuition. This has been a very powerful and it was an energy that took me a little bit of traversing to get used to, you know, because Neptune moves so slowly, you know, and it's something that, like, they're telling me 22:53 at the moment, you know. So in an opposition, they're still going to be opposed in a conjunction, like, or in an orb, you know, from the 21 degree through to the 23 degree mark, you know, of my sun. And so I'm just giving you that as an example, so that, you know, considering my progressed sun is Scorpio, you know, that changes the whole dynamic of that, of what I'm working through this year, but also natally what I'm actually having to integrate and transcend in this physical vessel in order to fulfill my purpose and keep going, you know. So I'm going to leave it there, Virgo. Please like, share and subscribe. Stay tuned to this channel because I'm going to be dropping another video in the next 24 hours of a beautiful announcement, divine announcement that I just can't wait to share with you all. I've been sitting on it for over a month now. And yes, please check out the description box on how you can work with me one-on-one, and I'll catch you in the next video. Okay, bye. Next up is Capricorn. Capricorn, this is hitting off in your house, the 10th house. The 10 of Wands was just the cut then of the deck. So Capricorn, considering this is transiting Libra moon ruled by Venus, transiting your 10th house, I'm really feeling that like this is going to really assist you in consolidating, is the word they're giving me right now, consolidating what it is that you want in your career, as opposed to what you've been telling yourself you need to do, is the phrase they're giving me, you know. So what cards, what messages, please, do we have for Capricorn? Here we go, the first two flipped out. Yep, the World card. I believe you had this in your last reading as well, Capricorn, for the Virgo moon, so you might want to go back and look at that. This also really gives me the Saturnian ring vibes of the planet with the wreath surrounding the woman. So, and then the Eight of Cups. So you are walking away from something, and as I was saying, you're consolidating something with how you're feeling about your career, how you're feeling about where you're headed in your life, you know. And with Saturn retrograding in Aquarius right now, Saturn is the god of time, Chronos, you know, the lord of time, and relates to karma specifically. So he's going to come in and he's going to ask you, well, did you do all of the things that you said you wanted to do, you know? And this is how you treat yourself, Capricorn. Like, I know, you know, like my progressed moon has been Capricorn, so I know what it's like to be on yourself all the time, to be like, well, you didn't do X, Y, and Z, you know, like, give yourself some freaking credit, man. Like, my God, you work so, so hard, you know. Can you please give us me, oops, it just fell on the floor. Excuse me. It's the Nine of Wands. Don't worry about the past, Capricorn. It's the past for a reason. It was there to teach you. So learn from it and move forward, okay? Underlying energies is the card for Taurus, the Hierophant here, which is also ruled by Venus as well, you know? So trust what your own inner spiritual guidance says, you know? Like, what is it that you really are passionate about? What is it that you can see yourself doing for, you know, the next 10 years that makes you really happy and joyful? Like, you know, for me, it's doing what I'm doing, like not just card readings, but like I love astrology, I love psychic channeling, I love helping people transcend, you know, the humanness that we've been so programmed and conditioned to be in, you know. Like, we live in a quantum hologram, and it's like, well, we are the alchemists of our reality, you know. We can really make anything happen that we wish, as long as we do the inner work to clear all the human shit out of our lower three chakras and do the healing work, you know. And then we can align with our divine purpose, our soul purpose, our hearts, you know. And as Carlos Castaneda says, you know, it's the path of the heart that matters and nothing else. You know, to not walk the path of the heart, well, what sort of life is that? You know, so may we have a clarifier, please, for Capricorn? The deck feels really sticky right now, Capricorn. So, like, please loosen up. Like, give yourself some breathing room, you know, and loosen your grip on trying to control everything, All right, so can we please have a clarifier for Capricorn? There it is, the Death card. What was I just saying? Surrender and just like do what it is in your heart. Live your truth, Capricorn. Nothing else matters in this life. You're living your life for you and nobody else. You know, and the Hierophant coming out earlier as well, that's the card for spirituality, religion, indoctrination, like institutions, governments, you know, and dogma, you know, and old paradigms, archaic paradigms that don't align with everybody's heart and soul, you know. So with the Death card here and then the underlying energies, you can't make it up. It's the Fool card. And what was I saying with the World and the Eight of Cups? You are closing out a cycle, and I'm just getting covered in chills right now, Capricorn. So I really, really like, I can't stress this enough. Like, just chill, Capricorn, you know, like, and just flow and let it all just happen. Because once you make a decision, the universe conspires to help you. And to have it happen, you know, and trust me, like, I can't wait to get to share this announcement in the next 24 hours because, you know, it's just proven fact. Like, I made a decision, this thing came in, you know, then I had made the decision to leave this house and I had to sell a whole bunch of furniture and, you know, organize packing and moving, and as well as this new beautiful opportunity which actually wants to begin on the exact same day I'm moving house. You know, like, come on, like, how can you not believe that life is magical, Capricorn? I think in your last reading this came up as well, all right? It was about you were so focused on the material 3D aspects of the physicality of this reality when in fact it's a quantum hologram. And you need to be in touch more with your intuition and more in with your, thank you so much. They just said more with your divine essence of the magic of you being a divine soul, okay? So surrender to what it is that your soul is trying to tell you and make the moves, you know? We are, and you know, as Saturn goes retrograde, it will be a really good idea for you to revise, you know, over. So if it's going back to 6 degrees, I'm not even going to try and guess. No, I'm not going to try and guess when. Maybe December? I want to say December. They're telling me December. Okay. Which is in alignment with the Pluto retrograde we're experiencing right now. And the Death card does relate to Scorpio and Pluto. So look back to the 30th of December 2020 and the first week of 2021. You know what was coming up for you then. Okay. And, thank you, July as well is coming up. July of 2020 is coming up right now for you as well. So yeah, Capricorn, I'm going to leave it there. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please like, share and subscribe and check out the description box on how you can work with me one-on-one. And stay tuned to this channel because I'll be dropping another video with my announcement in the next 24 hours. Thank you all so much for being here, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye.